Hey guys, I'm Sana, and I'm here to show you how to set up your computer.
I thought we were here to teach them how to play a game called Turing Tumble.
Marie, Turing Tumble is both a computer and a pretty awesome game.
This does not look like a computer to me.
That is because it's a mechanical computer, not an electronic one, like you're used to.
I've never heard of a mechanical computer before.
We will get to that, but first, let's show them how to set up their computer.
That I can do. These are the materials that come with your game. A board with legs that create a stand. If you try to assemble your stand and your board doesn't fit on it, switch it around and try it again. Red and blue marbles. I like to keep my board in my box top so my marbles don't bounce away. And you have 6 different pieces you can keep inside of your box.
Each of those parts play a special role in your computer.
And my favorite part, your puzzle book. You get to follow the story of Aaliyah, the space engineer, who gets trapped in outer space, and she can't escape until she solves some pretty intense challenges. When you play the game, you get to build the pieces on the board to solve the puzzle.
Right, but that is only when you start building your computer. When we use a game piece switches, gears, and bits to create a machine to solve the challenges, it is computing. If this board were bigger, like the size of Texas, it could do anything, solve any challenge your computer could.
Cool.
Yeah, but before we can start with our very first challenge, we need to remember to start from the beginning. In every challenge, you get to learn a new concept, so don't skip ahead. Page 15 of our puzzle book is where we will start with our first challenge. So let's go there.
Got it. Page 15.
Every challenge has an objective at the top of the page. You need to create a computer that completes the challenge. The first challenge, make all of the blue marbles and only the blue marbles reach the end.
Check out the starting setup. You need to set the board up just like this. The blue marbles are on the top left and the red marbles are on the top right. There are 6 different green ramps in the spots shown. We put 8 blue marbles on the top left and 8 red marbles on the top right. Don't put all of the marbles on top. We put the 6 green ramps in the spots shown, and now the presser right here on the left.
I'm gonna start the computer by pressing the start button. Watch what happens.
Uh-oh, we've got marbles bouncing all over the place. This is not right.
That is what happens when you are too quick to push the presser. You have to add more parts. Right next to the starting setup is a column called Available Parts. You need to figure out where the 4 extra ramps go.
All right, we have 4 extra green ramps. I'll put them here, 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 and here.
Okay, now when I press the start button, wow, check it out. The marbles are guided all the way down the board. Remember to only press the start button once. If you solve the challenges, the marbles will fall down correctly on their own.
Oh my gosh, we made all of the blue marbles reach the end. This was an easy one to solve, but don't worry, the challenges get a lot harder.
As you master the challenges, you get to read more of the comic book story and new parts are unlocked. The first part to be unlocked is the orange crossover.
The crossover puzzles are really fun. You can make blue marbles crossover and trigger the right lever, releasing red marbles.
And when a red marble falls, it will cross over and trigger the left lever, releasing blue marbles.
The second part to be unlocked is the blue bit. You choose whether it points right or left, and that stores information for later. When a marble passes through, it flips the bit and it stays pointed in the new direction.
The third part to be unlocked is the Black Interceptor. It's cool because you can program the board to stop running at any chosen time.
Oh my gosh, that's cool.
But the last parts to be unlocked are our favorites.
Gears and gear bits.
The purple gear bits and red gears make it Turing complete. That means it could do anything, solve any challenge your computer could, if only it were big enough.
With the gear and gear bits, you can do amazing things. Similar to the blue bits, you choose if they are pointed left or right, and when a marble passes through, it passes information back up the board.
We know you are going to love building your own marble-powered computers. Remember to work at your own pace, and don't skip ahead, because every challenge helps you learn something new.
And don't worry if you get stuck on a puzzle. You can get some additional practice hints and practice puzzles at TuringTumble.com.
Now it is time for you to build your own marble-powered computers
with Turing Tumble.